No, I think there's been an eerie atmosphere actually in the first half, towards the end of the first half, Mike. I think Sligo fans stunned by the lack of performance, and Roscommon fans stunned by the quality of the performance. And I think it'll, you know, if it gets close in the next few minutes, I think we'll see both sets of fans really getting stuck in.
So the second half is up and running. Sligo will play from right to left. This is Johnny Davey. The shot is not going to carry, and Geoffrey Claffey takes it in under his arm and gets it away to safety. Shawnee McDermott now. Player putting in the tackle is Keelan Cawley. Carl Mannion in towards his half-forward line, which is absent without leave. And now Alan Costello. Again, much like the start of the first half, it's fairly hectic. Adrian Marin trying to put the ball dead. And that's as good a score as we've seen today. His third point of this Connacht final. Where somebody needs to take this match by the scruff of the neck and give it some direction. It is Roscommon's to win if they could just kick on. Push in the back on David O'Gara. Another free. And this will bring Donal Shine back into the spotlight once more, and a chance for him to make amends.
Yeah, again, the quality has gone out of the game. There's a lot of individual errors been made. There's a lot of, you know, silly frees been given away. That was, again, an easy free to give away in that position. Certainly the tempo, and we talked about it in the first half, Mike, it is very, very hot here in McHale Park. It's very warm out there, it's humid, and both sides put in a huge performance in the first half. And Sligo have emptied the bench early in this second half, so, you know, will that freshness help for us? Common, I don't think, have made a substitute at this stage.
So Donal Shine from Clannagale kicking into the wind. So far, he's got 6 points, five wides. You can make that seven. Much better. He gave an exhibition of kicking in the first half. Fluffed his lines a little early in this second period, but that was right on the money. We do believe has just merited a yellow card for the Roscommon corner forward. Here's Charlie Harrison sallying up from corner back and firing that ball over the bar. He's roaring to his teammates for more effort. If that doesn't lift them, nothing will. What a time to kick your first point of the championship. Back to a three-point game again. David Casey, you wonder, where did he get his energy? The 28-year-old wing back to Mannion. Once more pulling the strings, feeding it through to Donal Shine. He can kick off either foot. That looks good. What a score from Donal Shine. He has treated us to a masterclass in shooting. Left, right and centre. And that has got the Roscommon supporters on their feet.
Well, that's an unbelievable score, because he was out in the corner against the wind again. Kicks it with his left foot. A beautiful striking action straight over the black spot. Incredible score for Donal Shine. He's only 21.
That patience proves a virtue, though, and away they go. Sean Davey. Quick look up. Just one man to aim at. That's David Kelly. This time he's away from McDermott. Drops the shoulder. Gone for the goal. Good stop by Geoffrey Claffey. The Roscommon goalkeeper got down quickly, but he has touched the ball on the ground. Sligo will get a free. They may well get a point. They were looking for a goal.
Well, I'd like to see that one again, because it was a great save. Great take by David Kelly. Took on Shawnee McDermott and went by him. And wonderful save by Geoffrey Claffey. He stood up and blocked the ball. And again, what happens here afterwards, I think he says he picked it straight off the ground. And he's right, a good decision by the referee.
Geoffrey Claffey hasn't conceded a goal yet in the championship. He keeps that clean sheet for now, and Mark Brahenny takes the point. But still plenty of time for Fergal O'Donnell to shake things up. O'Hara needs support from Brahenny. Once more, the momentum gone out of that attack. Alan Costello with the wind in his back. That is a majestic score from Alan Costello. Straining every muscle to get to that ball. Sligo have possession. Kenneth Sweeney. Again, very little to aim at inside. Adrian Marin it is who makes the run. Stephen Ormsby with him for company. And Costello now. A rare chance to turn David Casey into a defender. He's gone for it again. And he's got it again. That is superb from Alan Costello. It's back to a one-point game.
Who defend a lead often become unstuck. They become so determined about defending that they forget about attacking.
Sean Davey, he has gone for a two. He backed himself, and wasn't it a wise decision? Sligo substitutes now are beginning to make an impact, just like they did against Galway. Roscommon's full back line under pressure, but that's a fine take by Shawnee McDermott. He was backpedalling. He needed to make sure. And the corner back from Western Gales didn't put a foot wrong. This is Peter Domakin, the Roscommon captain, driving out and along with Michael Finneran, not prepared to take no for an answer, but he's been fouled.
They have more experience, of course, and they want to win this game badly. And, you know, beating Galway and Roscommon, or Galway and Mayo in the Connacht Championship and not winning the Connacht Final, they'd regard it as a huge opportunity missed. And they're the team with the momentum at this stage.
Roscommon have a free, though. It was good work initially by Kevin Higgins. Come at the hour, come at the man. And that means it's time for Donal Shine once more to take on the responsibility. The angle would suit a right-footed kicker, but this is the closing minutes of a Connacht final. He's never experienced an atmosphere quite like this. It's a big kick. He's nailed it. Nerves of steel from the young full forward from Clannagale. Roscommon are back in front.
A wonderful kick from Donal Shine. Whatever the result is today, Donal Shine can hold his head high. He's had an unbelievable performance.
Jonathan Dunning, he's in for David O'Gara. Remember, it's 9 years since that Jerry Lohan goal broke the Mayo hearts. Can Costello break Roscommon hearts? Well, at the very least, he's kicked Sligo level.
Fantastic performance.
We're level for the third time here at McHale Park in Castlebar. Will we have a winner or will we have a second day out? That's a foul. No doubt about it. Neil Ewing it was who tackled Jonathan Dunning. It was Derek Duggan back in 91 who kicked the winning point for Roscommon. Donal Shine steps up to the plate and drills it over the bar. 10 points in a Connacht final. He will not need any encouragement to sleep tonight. Roscommon lead. We're into the final 90 seconds.
Well, it's been an extraordinary day for both teams and, you know, a game of two halves, obviously. Roscommon completely dominant in the first half, you know, and Donal Shine putting in a tremendous performance of, you know, free-taking and points from play. And on the other side, Alan Costello as well, kicking 5 points from play. But man of the match has to be, for me, Donal Shine, for a 21-year-old to take on the responsibility, play at full forward in a pivotal position and have such an influence in this game. 10 points in a Connacht Champ final in his first game. Donal Shine is our man of the match. Absolutely vital. It's all over.
Would you believe it? The 4-1 outsiders have torn up the form book yet again. And Roscommon are Connacht champions for the first time in 9 long, hard years. Fergal O'Donnell's young team have delivered the county's 20th Connacht senior title. And maybe, just maybe, for one night only in places like Castlereagh, French Park and Roscommon Town, the recession will be over. Sligo, the raging hot favourites, have been beaten here in Castlebar. Their dreams of a fourth title dashed. The Nestor Cup is going back to Roscommon. It's their day, and they will go back to Croke Park for an All-Ireland quarter-final as Connacht champions. A pitch invasion at McHale Park in Castlebar. And hard to blame those Roscommon supporters. They've known a lot of hard days, a lot of dark days. But they are high kings of Connacht yet again. What a Connacht final these two teams served up.